me feel nervous. You have that look in your eye. Oh, what takes over? What is it that holds you tight? And you can tear it up. Oh, no one tears it up like you. Oh, you can rip it up. Oh, no one rips it up like you. When you're in the half-light, it is not you I see. You live a half-life. You only show half to me.
I miss my friends.
What possesses you? Oh, what possesses you?
Well, that's enough of that. Let's get going. All right, so this is actually one of the most confusing yet useful activities you'll probably ever do in chemistry as it relates to a concept that's really, really strange. So I'm going to try and split screen this thing here so we can make the most sense out of it as possible. You'll have me working kind of in the background of this whiteboard, and then sort of to the side, I'll be sort of scrolling through the document called the Atom Hotel. So let's read this together. So your task is read this passage, determine the assignment of electrons to their rooms in order to check for the electrons under the Atom Hotel. To do this, you may use a separate sheet of paper, draw a picture, flow diagram, outline, whatever you think's best. So you're going to see me draw a picture, because with pictures, it sort of seems to resonate a little bit better. So forgive me a little bit here. The writing here gets a little bit weird. So here we go. So deep in the depths of the atomic realm, there exists a haven for a wayward and wary electron transfer, the traveler, the Adams Hotel. It is not a plush resort, but it is very serviceable, discreet, distinctly stylish place. It has a lobby containing a check-in desk, a very attractive restaurant, and an electronic game room. There is no pool. Electrons can get short-circuited out when in water. Electrons occupy the hotel with great frequency and will take quantum leaps to get there. There's so many terrible jokes embedded in that paragraph. Moving on. Above the ground level lobby, there are 7 levels of rooms. Okay, so that whole first thing about the, like, what the lobby looks like. I'm gonna just kind of sort of draw a lobby. So I have some sort of a lobby down here. And then it's giving me some details to the side and saying, okay, so above the lobby, there are 7 levels of rooms. So I have 7 levels. Okay, so 7 floors, I guess, each having its own style and decor. The first level, for example, has only one room, a suite room that has one double bed. It's the number one priority for traveling electrons due to the nearest to the ground level, and it has ample amenities. In fact, the ground level rooms are extremely popular to electrons because they want to expend the least amount of energy necessary to get to their rooms. And they are not at all bashful about sharing their accommodations with fellow electrons in order to occupy these key locations. What? Okay, let's read on. The second level has 2 total rooms. It has a suite with a double bed and a party room with 3 double beds. Okay, so the first floor just has a suite room, which has 1 bed in it. The second floor has a suite room and it has a party room, which has 3 beds in it. Okay, got it. Still doesn't really make any sense. Let's keep going. All right, traveling the grounds. Okay, the third level is similar and it consists of 3 rooms. So my third level has the suite room, which is the 1 bed, the party room, which is the 3 beds, and then what's the newest one on here? It also says it has a dorm room. So a D, which has 5 beds. Okay. When the electron gets to the fourth level, things follow the same pattern. And there's 1 suite with 1 double bed, 1 party room with 3 double beds, 1 dorm room with 5 beds, and then 1 far... this is getting annoying. So the fourth floor has the suite, has the party, has the dorm, and now... just to make it even more confusing, has the far away room, which I'm guessing is extremely far, which has 7 double beds in it. Okay. However, due to budget cuts, the architect floors for 5, 6, and 7 are the same. Oh, sweet. So 4th through the 7th floor are the same. Got it. They're all the same. It's going to follow that pattern. All right. Let's see if it makes some sense. Okay. So moving on. So registration. When the traveling electron arrives at the hotel, it must first register at the front desk with Squiggy Adam. Squiggy will assign the electron to a bed, which is available as near as possible to the lobby on the ground level. The following registration procedure will be carried on as long as the electrons check in. First of all, they want to go to the nearest room. Okay, so we want, number one, the nearest room. Got it. Okay. Okay. One electron per bed. So number two, one electron per bed. Okay. Until the room is filled. Wait. One electron per bed until the room is filled with 2 electrons per bed. Okay, wait. So one per bed, but 2 electrons is apparently okay. All right. Did you remember that every room has equipped with double beds? It should be noted at this point that electrons snore. It is for this reason that when the electrons share a double bed, they must sleep on opposite ends. So if they have 2, we're going to have 1 sleep this way and 1 sleep that way. So kind of up or down away from each other. Okay, perfect. Got it. Whew. All right. So snoring is repulsive and electrons are not attracted to each other as it is. So let us allow Squiggy to register some electrons. Squiggy will direct the first electron to the elevator at the end of the hall. The electron will get off the first floor. Remember, the lobby's the ground floor. And proceed to the suite room in the first level. Sweet indeed. Okay, I need to redraw this thing because this doesn't make any sense. I have a lobby and then I'm just have all these details. Okay, so, and this will happen to you a lot with this activity. I know that I've got the lobby sitting at the bottom. And then apparently there's some kind of elevator. But I'm going to draw the rest of my hotel out so I can sort of see where I'm going. So there's my lobby, which is my ground floor, right? This is the ground. And then we've got the first level, the second, the third, the fourth, and man, I hope I have enough space, the fifth, the sixth, and the seventh got really big up there. So the first level, second level, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and then seventh is really, really big. All right, now in the first level, if you remember from our notes from before, there's only a suite room, which has the one bed. The second level has a suite, and it has another room, which is a little further away, called the party room, which has 3 beds. Okay, I'm good so far. Third floor still has the suite, still has the party. And then it also has the dorm room, which has 5 beds. This is getting crazy. Fourth floor has the suite, has the party, has the dorm. My beds are getting smaller. And has the faraway room, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then it repeats itself. So I'm going to make these little lines kind of all the way through these other floors just so we can see them a little bit better. Now, I'm going to assume I've got some elevator kind of down the side here. And I'll draw the rest of those things in a second. But right now, I don't need them just yet. So I got my suites, my parties, my dorms, and my far away. And it's not to the fourth floor that the parties show up. So I've got these suites. These parties might come into play here. So I'll draw them. Suites. Suites, parties, parties. And my goal is to try and figure out, well, how do these electrons fill in? And they want to go as close to the lobby as possible because the lobby, we're going to find out, is actually the nucleus. And these dorm rooms or these far away rooms are actually something we know as electron orbitals. So earlier in this unit, actually it was more like unit 1, I had talked about, hey, are the electrons orbiting like the planets? And the answer was, well, no, but don't worry about what they're doing. Now we're kind of starting to worry about what they're doing. We want to know where the electrons are. We want to know what their address is. And so our entirely fitted Adam Hotel looks something like this. So now if we're going to check in electrons, and I'm just going to flip colors so I can see it a little better, I'm going to follow what Squiggy says. So Squiggy's going to say, all right, so suite one, they're going to lay at the other end of the bed. Okay, so the end of the hall, they're assigned to the same room. So I've got suite one and then laying the opposite direction to be electron number two. Okay, so that room is totally filled. That's where Squiggy sent them up. All right, makes sense. Okay, as more and more electrons stop at the night, they'll have to be assigned to a party room on the second level after we fill down the suite from the first, okay, which is further down the hall on the other. Remember, the electrons are likely to get as close to the ground level as possible, and they'll make a quick exit if necessary. Now, since there are three double beds in the party room, two, the first electron into the room gets its choice of beds, the second electron gets its choice of the two beds, and the remaining gets the third one. You must realize that although electrons do not mind sharing, they will occupy an empty bed in the room if it is available. Okay, so one and two pop in there. Three and four pop into my suite room. Now, apparently, five, six, and seven are going to spread out and have their own bed. When the eighth electron checks in, it finds that suite one is full, suite two is full, and the party room just has one electron in each bed, all sleeping at the same end. You must therefore double up with one of the electrons sleeping on the opposite end, of course. Same accommodations are available in the 9th, 10th electrons. So that means 8, 9, 10. Fill in like so. Okay. All right. They share the electrons in party room 2. As more and more electrons arrive, they are assigned in the following manner. Level 1 to level 2 are now full, so 2 electrons go to level 3 suites. Then the 6 go to level 3's party room. Okay, so 11 and 12 would go to the suite, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and then we have, oh no, Squiggy. Uh-oh, Squiggy got sick, and Squiggy died. We'll have to bury him. That's a terrible joke. All right, luckily for you, Squiggy left some extra information so you could plan out where every electron should go, maximum 118, or else radioactive fires tend to break out in the dough. This is just full of terribleness. So your job is to lay out the hotel map where 180 electrons would reside when the hotel were full, assuming they register one at a time. Okay, so in suite 1, 2, and party room, suite 3, and party room, we've got all those filled so far. So here's the option. We can either occupy the dorm room, one of its 5 beds, or we could go up to the 4th level in the suite. After all, electrons want to get as close to the lobby as possible. And if you look, this dorm room is actually pretty far from the elevator as compared to the suite. So it turns out the 19th electron actually jumps up here, same with the 20th. But then the 21st would jump down to the dorm room, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Okay, and then now what? Well, after 30, we pop back up to this party room because that's the next most close room that's unoccupied. So 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36. And so if you watch how we're filling these in, it's almost like we're zigzagging. And so after this would pop up 36, this would be 37, 38. And then we would zigzag all the way down to the dorm room. 39, 40, 41, 42, 43. 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, and you kind of get the picture. And it just keeps zigzagging all the way through. And when we end up doing it, we stop. 118 ends up being in the party room on the 7th level. And these rooms on the very outer edge are totally unoccupied. So what do we need to know about this for chemistry? Well, this is actually the entire sequence or addresses that exist for electron configurations. Now, what I tend to tell kids is the Atom Hotel is great. It gives you a sweet visualization with this. But there's also sort of just like kind of a sillier way to look at it. And if we were just to sort of write this down as, okay, the first floor is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? Those are our 7 hotel levels that exist in the Atom Hotel. Well, in the first level, we just have the suite room. The second level, we have the suite, and we have a second level party. We have a suite, we have a third level party, and a third level dorm. A suite, a party, a dorm, and the faraways show up on the 4th level. Okay, suite, party, dorm, far away, because these all just repeat themselves as we continue on. And now we already know that it's going to stop at the seventh party room, but we can actually remember it by kind of doing it this way and almost drawing a line to sort of show us what order these things will go in. So normally what will happen is we will go like this, and we'll fill the first floor, 1S. Then the 2S would be filled. After 2S comes 2P, and then 3S. After 3S comes 3P. Now here's the trick. It actually jumps to the fourth level before it goes to that third. And it's kind of like our zigzag. Then it goes to the 3D, the 4P, and the 5S. After the 5S, we'd go to the 4D, the 5P, the 6S. After the 6S, you go 4F, 5D, 6P, 7S. 5F, 6D, 7P, and then we'd stop because these last three are unoccupied. Now, what on earth does this mean? Well, this is getting us into something called electron energy diagrams and eventually electron configurations.
So what is the Atom Hotel actually trying to show us? Honestly, it's taking this model that we already have, this Bohr model with rings. And if you look at the levels here, we go 1 through 7, but it's explaining it in much more detail. Because in reality, it doesn't look like this. This would be assuming that electrons are orbiting like the planets do in these circular rings. And even if we quantize these levels, like you've seen before, where the levels get closer together, you know, something more like this, it still doesn't really account for what we're really looking at. Because in truth, what happens is that these electrons are doing two different things. These electrons are trying to get close to the nucleus because opposites attract. Yet at the same time, they're also trying to avoid one another because like charges repel. And if electrons are negative and the nucleus itself is positive, well, the negative and positives are going to attract, but the like negatives sitting in those clouds are going to be repelling. And so we tend to see something more like this, with this incredibly strange arrangement of probability clouds. And this is very challenging to look at. This is hard to work with. So instead, we talk about this idea of where these things can exist on an electron energy diagram. So if you can imagine that we took a look at the atom and we basically split it right down the middle. So we had the nucleus sort of shown only in kind of a half here. And you could work any direction since these clouds are working in three dimensions. But we only need to work in one direction away from the nucleus so we can see where these electrons are. That's kind of a weird concept to think about. But in essentially what we're saying is the clouds that we've been seeing, we don't have to draw their entire form. We just have to kind of draw where they are. And I usually tend to draw these, just like most other chemistry people, going upward or away from the nucleus, because the higher in energy they are, the further they are from the nucleus. Now you got to keep in mind, these things start getting much, much closer together as they start getting further away. And so we start having what's known as energy orbital overlap. And so what we'll do is you actually start to get a view of the Atom Hotel, where the first floor is the 1S, which stands for the sharp function, but it's not really super important to us. Our suite room has one bed, which can occupy two electrons, one of an upspin and one of a downspin. Now, if we go to the second level, we can see, hey, there's two possibilities. We have a suite room and a party room. The party room, or the P, stands for the principal function, which has three beds. And in this case, you can see, well, it's possible to double up or be in singles. The third floor has the S, the P, and the D. But if you look carefully, as we start getting that further away in that level, the fourth and third level start to overlap a little bit because those energy levels are getting closer and closer together. And so if we think about what this is truly trying to show us, all it's showing us is that every single electron has its own individual address. Consider the electron that is the downward electron in the 2p orbital. No other electron can have that exact same address. You cannot have another down electron in the 2p orbital in that one orientation. It doesn't exist. There's only one possibility for every single one. And so this map, this electron energy diagram, is essentially what the Atom Hotel was doing for you. Yeah, we were talking suites, parties, dorms, and faraways, but it's all the exact same letterings. And this is a map of what the electrons are actually supposed to be doing and where they actually are. Now, with this, we can take it a step further and start writing directions instead of an address, or essentially taking this map and synthesizing it into one place, which is known as an electron configuration. And so if the Atom Hotel isn't enough to help you sort of remember this order, good news. The entire periodic table is already laid out in perfect order for you. It goes exactly in the blocks or exactly in the orientation of the electrons that are already shown. All you have to remember is that there are various blocks that exist, but you have this as a resource. So if you look, for example, starting at hydrogen in the upper left-hand corner, that is the first energy level, the first row of the periodic table. It's in the S block because it's a block of elements that only has room for two electrons or one bet. If you were to go down to the fifth element of boron, that's the second row, but now it's in a P block. And if you count, there's six total elements that exist, or six total columns in that case, meaning that there's three total bets. Transition metals in the middle would be our D block, and then our lanthanides and actinides sitting at the very bottom would be our F block. And so as you follow through, all you're really counting is what energy level you're on, what sublevel, and then how many electrons are actually sitting there. I don't memorize these things in order. I'm just going to read off my periodic table. So if I want to know specifically tin, what level it's actually sitting in, I know it's the fifth energy level, specifically the P orbital, and it would have two electrons sitting in that fifth P orbital. Now, all of this sort of basically gives us an idea for how we can actually create something known as an electron configuration. And I'll use this a lot more than I will an electron energy diagram, which is more of our map.